hey, you put that on treetop, you see me hit the ground, nigga hit me? You seen that?
What's good with it, Rizzle fam? So, we got some brand new news about Slim 400's death, thanks to Wack 100. And what he had to say about the whole thing might come as a bit of a shock. Wack did a Clubhouse interview recently where he talked about all sorts of things. The biggest topic that came up were Pop Smoke and his death, the current state of the streets in Los Angeles, and Slim 400's death. For those of you who don't know exactly what went down just yet, on the 8th of December 2021, some dudes pulled up on Slim 400 and gunned him down. He was sitting in a driveway in his car when someone walked up and fired some shots into the driver's side window. He got out of the car and walked up the road just a little bit before his injuries became too much and he collapsed. He was hanging out in a city that neighbors his hometown of Compton Inglewood. Cops showed up and an ambulance drove him over to a hospital, but he didn't make it. Fan theories have been flying since Slim died, with people thinking it basically could have been anything. Maybe he was in the wrong place at the wrong time, maybe it was a case of mistaken identity, or it could have been the case that it was actually a victim of planned shooting. If what Wack had to say is true though, there wasn't anything random about it. Instead, what happened is that Slim shouldn't have been in that neighborhood in the first place. He said,
Slim wasn't supposed to be over there like that anyway. He wasn't supposed to be over there. You know, it's a war going on over there. I mean, you're on a block, a nigga gonna come through. So it's like, there's a war going on over there with the homies. So it's like.
Apparently, he was on the ops turf, or at the very least, it was contested territory. Someone spotted him and took care of it. One of the worst parts of the whole situation is that according to Wack, he was trying to put Slim onto a whole new thing anyway. Wack wanted Slim to get out of the streets and into stand-up comedy just before everything went down. If that would have worked out the way Wack wanted, maybe Slim would still be here. But at the same time, it's not like he still didn't have ties to gang life. Obviously, comedy is a little further out than rap, but you can't just put stuff like that down. Wack said,
I just had a conversation with that nigga too, man. I've been trying to get that nigga to go do stand-up comedy for about 3 years now. Talking to Ghazi 4 days ago, and I said the same. Now he just called me and said, what? You just said Slim need to get out the street and go do stand-up comedy.
Some fans seem to agree with what Wack said. One of them tweeted, it would have been cool living in LA County. Wish he would have just stopped hitting his block. Had enough bread to stay in the hills, but kept visiting Bumped. Sad day. Prayers to his family and loved ones. Another user called out the whole problem that the trap set someone up in saying, the cycle of black men that come from the streets, I pray for y'all, and the enemies you think you have. I pray for your retirement from this cycle that constantly devastates your loved ones. I pray your seeds have a chance to see something different. God bless. While it would have been great if Slim would have popped out to the suburbs instead of visiting the hood, there's a good chance that he wouldn't have been shot, but the problem is that he still had homies there. I mean, he grew up with YG, featured on a lot of his music, and basically blew up as a result of that relationship. So like, it's not all as easy as that to put down. The worst part about all this stuff is honestly that Slim was just visiting some friends. It wasn't like he even needed to be there for real. That makes things even more tragic. Since the whole thing went down, Wack said that there's a war going on, and that's also pretty consistent with what the police are saying about the whole thing. The LAPD came out and said they think the whole thing is a case of gang-related retaliation. According to the cops, there's been a big increase in violence between the Bloods and the Crips in Los Angeles, and Slim was a well-known Blood affiliate. In fact, after the shooting, the cops decided that they needed to put more police on the streets as a result of the gang war that was brewing. They also wanted tourists to be careful when hanging out in LA. When Slim said that he shouldn't have been in that area anyway, he's probably saying that he wasn't on the right turf, and that's what's got him shot. They believe Slim happened to be in the wrong place at the wrong time, and his alleged ties to the Bloods didn't help. The cops are basically saying that they don't think the ops were after Slim in specific, but they did see him out and about. Cops also said that while the shooter probably wasn't going after Slim specifically, they thought the whole thing was some sort of revenge deal for something that Slim might have done in the past, or they just did it to send a message. To make matters worse, there's the fact that Slim had already survived a shooting a couple years ago. He just barely made it out of that one alive, after being shot 9 times in Compton. While there haven't been any suspects' names released, there's a good chance that whoever shot him back in 2019 is the same squad who shot him in 2021. If it wasn't the exact same crew or the exact same shooter, it probably was for the same reason at the very least, and many think it's probably the Crips who got him. Now, people aren't exactly happy the way Wax handled the whole thing. He's been in some beef before, and some of them have been pretty big. but this could set him up for something bad. See, Wack posted a video of Slim getting shot, which had been caught on a Ring doorbell video. The whole thing is pretty rough. A dude walks up to the car, drags Slim out of the driver's seat, and starts blasting. And that's the end of the video. A lot of people have tried to play it like people are angry at Wack because they don't like his gang affiliation. But honestly, it's probably just the fact that you shouldn't do that. Not only that, but technically it's illegal to be sharing videos like that. They're a part of an ongoing police investigation. It's not just something you do. You gotta have some respect for the dead. Fans of Slim have a lot of opinions regarding this. One fan said, "Wack doesn't care." And this misunderstanding is the homie not realizing how much Wack didn't care prior to this. Respect for having integrity to not want to post the video. No matter if other platforms posted, and you had a relationship with Slim, and you know that posting it could upset his daughter and family, not posting it is the solid thing to do. Another fan tried to point out that there are two different sides to releasing the video, saying, "There's a good side to posting the video and a bad side. The bad side is that it's hurtful to the friends and family, but the good side is that the friends and family can see the video and perhaps see dude's body structure and can hear his voice to possibly figure out who dude could be." But when Nipsey killing footage was going around the podcast platforms, nobody was saying nothing or tripping off of it being posted. Like I said, showing that video can perhaps get him identified. And I'm not talking about no arrest. Where he's coming from on this one makes sense, but at the same time, there's really no way to figure out who it was from the footage. It's really grainy and it's hard to make out any facial features. So what do y'all think about this? Is Wack in the right one on this, or should he have just kept the video to himself in the first place? You think it was related to the Crips and Blood War that's been getting more and more intense? And if you thought this was messy, wait till you check this video.